In the unit Applications of Biology, we have the topic of biotic community that we are going to start with now. And in this topic, you are going to get back into your knowledge of ecology that you have gained from previous class, that is class 11th knowledge of ecology. Now, what was ecology? Ecology was study of ecosystems. Now, when we study about ecosystem, it is basically the study within a given entity, that is the ecosystem, the study of interactions of the organism with the environment and other organisms. Now, when we study that ecosystem interactions, we deal with those interactions at a community level, and hence is the name biotic community. So, we are going to study about interactions within the biotic community of an ecosystem, but for understanding that, those interactions specifically, we are going to first of all know what an ecosystem structure is all about. So, the first lesson in this topic is about the ecosystem structure, where we are going to give a special reference to these three topics, and we are going to study the interactions between various species within an ecosystem according to these three structural composition, structural specializations of an ecosystem. Now, you know what is ecosystem? It is the basic entity of ecology. We often study the environmental interactions in a given area with reference to the ecosystem, okay? Supposedly, we are considering a pond ecosystem. It could be a forest ecosystem, tropical forest ecosystem. It could be a desert ecosystem. It depends which ecosystem we are taking into consideration. And over there, we often study its species composition, whatever stratification is present, the trophic structure of the ecosystem, standing crop, what is present in that given ecosystem, and the standing state. So, when we study these five things, we come to know the structure of ecosystem, and then we can get to know whether it is a pond ecosystem or vice versa, whether you know whether it is a pond ecosystem and then you come to these conclusions, or you know these things and then you come to a conclusion that whether it is pond ecosystem or it is grassland ecosystem, whichever ecosystem, those which are prevalent in the biosphere could be concluded to as a result of understandings and as a result of these five structural compositions. Now, what comprises the ecosystem structure is species composition, that how many species are present within an ecosystem. An ecosystem is said to be diverse and more suitable, or you can say it is considered as advanced ecosystem if it is having more number of species within it. So, species composition is an important aspect of ecosystem structure, that how many number of species are present, which all species are present in the given ecosystem. It gives the idea about the organisms which are present in the specific environment. Once this composition is understood, we have to move to the next structural specification, that is stratification. Now, in the case of tropical rainforest, you must have heard that there are certain layers. A layer which is the lowest one hardly receives any sunlight, and the topmost canopy layer receives so much sunlight. Then there are climbers which reach up to certain layer. Then there are animals which reach up to certain layer. So, there is vertical stratification. That means vertical layering is, there are various layers, and vertical layering is observed in the ecosystem structure. So, that is known as stratification. That means you find different compositions at different layers, okay? So, we find it in tropical rainforest specifically, or you can say in redwood trees, you are going to find a number of levels of stratifications. There could be birds at one level, there could be creepers at one level, there could be amphibians at one level, there could be mangrove growth at one level. So, we have various vertical levels within the ecosystem, and that is studied under stratification. And of course, I need not to say in desert, you are going to find least stratification because there would be no vegetation. Specifically, so vegetation layers comprises the stratification. Then we have the trophic structure. When we are studying an ecosystem, we have to study its trophic structure as well. Now, what is this trophic structure? That the interaction of an ecosystem in terms of food chain and food webs. So whatever food chain or food web you are having within an ecosystem, that is also an interspecific relationship where they are bound or they are connected to each other for the requirement of food, and it deals with productivity of one structure. And here we come across the terms like consumers, producers, decomposers, and of course primary consumers, secondary consumers, and many more terms. We would deal about it. As I told you in the beginning, these are the three topics that we have to deal in detail in context of biotic community. Then moving further, we have another structural specification, that is a standing crop. How much living matter, okay, or rather I would say living biomass is there in a given ecosystem. Preferably we go for dry weight instead of fresh weight. We go for dry weight because it is more accurate analysis as compared to the fresh weight. So the living biomass in given ecosystem, in a given ecosystem, is known as the standing crop of the ecosystem. And last one is the standing state. Now standing state refers to the inorganic nutrients which are present in the soil or water, in terrestrial or aquatic ecosystem respectively. So the quantity of inorganic nutrients in soil or water for respective ecosystems is known as standing state. So this is all we have in understanding the ecosystem structure. Now when we understand its structure, we have to see how these three factors are playing an important role in interactions. We said that ecology is all about interactions. Interactions at what level? At ecosystem level. So these three characteristic features of the structure are going to play an important role in interactions, and that we are going to study under our topic biotic community. So this was the introductory lesson. Now next lesson we are going to see, it would be a short one, we are going to see what would be the scope of our understanding in this topic.